Limpopo in a province in South Africa is a national he has a national teaching award winner at the Capricorn district. Is currently a facilitator at Bella Matrix ICT Foundation. Is also a co-creator and facilitator of the Online Teaching and Learning Academy with the support of Open Education for a Better World. He's also an agent at Landau School in the Caucasus region. So at this juncture, allow me to take this opportunity to welcome this great educator from South Africa. Welcome, Ismail.
Thank you very much, Mr. Felix. And greetings to everyone once more. Like they've already introduced me, I'm Ismail from South Africa, and then I'm going to take you through the MOODLE. Now, first of all, before I can start.
You're not very clear so long.
Okay. I don't know what I was saying. My apologies, colleagues. The laptop.
There's an echo from the background. Somebody else to devices.
Yes. All right, colleagues, without any waste of time, Mr. Felix already alluded that I only have 10 minutes to take you through MOODLE. So all I can say is that there is actually a lot that I wanted to share with you about MOODLE, but then because of the time constraint, I'm just going to emphasize on the key things. And then the rest of the other stuff, if you still want to know, then hook with me up and then I'll take you through it. I hope you can be able to see my screen.
We cannot see your screen.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, colleagues, like they've said, I'll be talking about MOODLE. So first of all, what is MOODLE? MOODLE is a free open source course management system, also called learning management system. And MOODLE is actually an acronym, which is for modular object oriented dynamic learning environment. And there is some key features of MOODLE.
There, sir, we cannot see your screen. There, sir, we cannot see your screen presentation.
Oh, you cannot see my screen. Sorry, let me stop sharing and share again. My apologies for that. I thought you said you can see my screen. Just a minute or a second, rather. All right. Please tell me if you can see it now.
Yeah. Now it's visible. Okay.
Right.
It's visible.
All right, lovely. So the key features of MOODLE, one of them is that you can build courses and add content to them. You can be able to create student assignments, tests, and quizzes. You can be able to view student submissions and track their progress. You can be able to add course deadline to the shared calendar. You can be able to generate reports on student participation. And last but not least, you can be able to define workflows for grading assessments with working with teachers and both learners, or let me just rather say other teachers. Now, with MOODLE, there was a question recently about do you have to download it or is it online? So with MOODLE, you need to download it first of all. And then for you to download MOODLE, you can just go to the net and type MOODLE, and then you'll get the version. The latest version currently is 3.11. So you can go there and search MOODLE and download it for PC, or you can alternatively use the link that I used here, but this one was for 3.6, of which after this it was 3.10, and currently we've got 3.11, which is the latest version. Now, when you install, after you downloaded the software or app, when you install it, You'll just have to go through this step. Step number one, you'll have to select the language. After selecting the language, it will say set up Bitnami Moodle Stack, and then it says welcome. You need to click next. After clicking next, you'll get the second screen on the left, which is for you to create the account. And then with creating the account, it will require the following details. It will first require your real name. It will require your email address and your username. And then the password, and also the password. So on the real name, that's where you put in your name, and then you put in your email address. On the login, you put in you can put in your name and your surname as your login details, just so that you cannot forget them. After you put in your information, you'll have to click next, and then it will take you to this site where you need to put in the site name. The site name is the name that will appear on your Moodle account. And then after that, you click next again. It will take you to the screen on the right, and then you'll have to uncheck here. There is a tick that it comes by default. You have to uncheck there. And then from here, you click next again, and then you click next again, and then it will start downloading. So you'll wait for it to install. And then one other thing that I wanted to show you is that whenever you want to install Moodle, it's very much crucial that sometimes you switch on your antivirus, because when antivirus is on, it sometimes take longer than expected to be able to install it. So if you can switch on your antivirus, and then you'll fast track the whole process. After installing, you'll get the screen on the left, which says finish, to show that it has finished installing. Then you click finish. After clicking finish, there is a screen on the right here where it says welcome, manage server, and server events. So you'll have to come to this screen. After coming to this screen, now we are going to change the servers because by default, there are certain settings on the servers which don't work sometimes when you want to upload some other content on the Moodle, particularly the content that is having a big size. So for you to be able to change the servers, you'll have to change only these three. These are the important ones: the maximum execution time, the post maximum size, and the upload maximum size. So whatever content you'll get there, you'll have to change it to 360. On post maximum size, whatever size, I'm saying whatever size because it depends on the versions. 3.6 is not the same as 3.10, and it's not the same as 3.11. So now on post maximum size, you'll have to change it to 500. And then on upload maximum size, file size, you'll have to change it to 500 also. So that if you want to upload big size file with big sizes, they will be able to go through. Now, after changing that, we now have to go and change the PHP settings. So with the PHP settings, you'll have to go. This one also depends on the kind of the gadget that you're using or the computer that you're using. You'll go to the local disk. Some local disks, they are written local disk C, some they are written A, some they are written whatever local disk a name is written there. You'll go there. After going there, you'll have to go to a Moodle. The version that you installed in this case will be Moodle 3.11. And then after going to Moodle 3.11, you'll have to go to PHP. And then after clicking on PHP, you'll have to go to the file tab. On the file tab, you'll have to click search next, or find next rather.
Yeah, so now
after clicking find next, it will give you the screen at the top where it is find one. So you will have to put, you type max and then underscore. Underscore is that sign that you get after zero on the keypad. Now, after searching max, the reason you have to put the underscore is that if you just say max, we have got so many max on this notepad. So you have to direct it on where exactly you want it to take you to. Now, you'll keep on clicking find next until you get the settings that we are going to change, right? You just keep on clicking next and next and next, changing those which I said you need to change. Once you do that, you go to the file tab again. On the file tab, you click save. Not save as, just save. All right? After clicking save, you can come here on the notepad and close it. It means you'll be done with the PHP settings. All right? So after you are done with the PHP settings, now we are going to restart our servers so that they can work with the PHP settings that you just inserted. Now, you'll go to the local disk again. You'll go to Moodle 3.11 again. The folder will be written Moodle 3.11. Now, once you're inside Moodle 3.11, you'll look for Manage Servers. You'll get it somewhere at the bottom. And then you go to Manage Servers. After Manage Servers, it will give you the screen on the right where it says Welcome, Manage Servers, and Server Event. All right? Now, our focus now should be only on Manage Server. So you'll click on Manage Servers. Once you click on Manage Servers, you'll get two servers. Right? So with those servers, you'll get the green lights, right? So once you get the green lights, like the one on the screen, you'll have to come down here where it says restart all. You click on restart all. After restarting all, your lights will now turn red to show that they are restarting. They will now turn red like a robot. They will turn red. Once they are done with restarting, they will go back to green. And then importantly, you need to make it a point that before you close this pop-up window, all your servers your lights should be back to green. Because if you close the server while one light was still green, was still red, it means that you'll terminate other stuff. The settings that we changed, they might not be uploaded on the system. So once you're done, we are continue. Once you're done, you go to your browser. It doesn't matter whether you're using Google Chrome, you're using Mozilla Firefox, you're using Microsoft Edge, it doesn't matter the browser that you're using. But then you go to the search, address bar. On the address bar, you'll type in the code 127.0.0.1. 127.0.0.1, that is the code. And then you search. After searching, you'll get this a window here on the right where it says awesome, Moodle is now installed. If you don't get this text here that says awesome, your Moodle is now installed, it means there might be some error that you omitted. You need to go back and redo what we just did recently. All right? Now, this is the screen you'll get. Once you get this screen, you'll have to come and click where it says access Moodle. Now we want to access it because we have created the account, we have changed the settings, and then now we want to access the account. So once you click on access account, it will now require your username and your password. Remember, the username is the one that you wrote back then when you were creating the account. So you'll put in that username and the password. And one thing also important is that if you forget your password or your username, there is no way you can retrieve it. I know there is a point where it says forgotten your username or password, but Moodle won't retrieve your password. You'll have to uninstall the whole program and install it again. So it's very much paramount important for you to note down and make sure that you don't forget your password and your username. Or let me rather just say your login credentials. So now, after you logged in, now we are going to learn how to upload users, because you have learners in the classroom and you want to create Moodle and then create courses for your learners, right? So now you need to learn how to upload the users on Moodle. You have to create a list on spreadsheet. Doesn't matter what type of spreadsheet, but here I use Excel. So you create a list on Excel. After creating a list on Excel, you'll have to put in username. The title should be username, password, first name, and last name. Also email. And another thing, make it a point that on the titles, there is no space between the words, because if you have space, it will give you error when you upload it on Moodle. Also, to be on the safe side, make it a point that they are all small letters. Because if you have one which is a capital letter, it will also give you some problems. So it's very much important that you leave it as small letters, and then you put in your name. You can generate as the username that you prefer. Like here, I use 2021-001-002-003, and so on and so forth, up until the last student. On the password, you can just create the password that you won't forget, because your learners are going to require that password. They are going to be required a password for them to log in. And then on the name, you can put in the name and the surname of the learners. And the names of the learners and the last name, it will be the surname of the learners and the email address. And on the email address, make sure that you put in the right email so that the learners will be able to use the email when they access the module. Once you are done with the list, you make it a point that you don't save it as spreadsheet or as presentation. No, it's not presentation, it's Excel, sorry. You don't save it as normal Excel type, but you rather change the type to CSV. You'll get the CSV, you just click the drop-down arrow on the saving type, you'll get CSV, right? You save it as CSV. Why do you have to save it as CSV? Because if you save it as any other type, you won't be able to upload it on Moodle. So it's very much paramount important that you save it as CSV. So now, once you click save, it will give you this dialog box to say, do you want to keep using this format? And you just click yes. Because once you click no, it will take you back. Now, we are going to upload our users that we generated on spreadsheet. For you to upload them, you need to remember, you need to go to the dashboard. Once you are on the dashboard, you go to site administration. Once you are on site administration, you go to users. Once you are on users, you go to upload users. That is the last thing, right? So once you go to upload users, you have to come here and click again. You have to come here and click choose a file, because you have to upload the users, the list of users rather. You have to come here and click on choose a file. And then you are going to choose a file from the location where you saved it. You remember the library, or rather the location where you saved it. You are going to upload it from there. Now, this one, it differs with computers, right? Now, on the CSV delimiter, some computers will accept the comma like this. So, but then once you leave it as comma and then you click on upload users, it gives you an error on delimiter. You have to come here and change the comma to semicolon, right? But firstly, you need to start with a comma, because some computers allows comma. So you need to use it like that. And then again, you need to come to upload file. You choose a file again. It will show you here once it's uploaded. On the author, you just have to leave it like that. Same as, leave it like that. And then you upload the file. The important part is only the file, not the other stuff. Now, to show that your list is being uploaded, you will see it like this. It will show you a list like this of the list of the users that you are uploading. And then once you see a list like this, you have to come and click on upload users. It means you'll be done with uploading users, right? It will now show you the number of users that you are creating or you are uploading. If there are 20, it will say users created is 20. If it's 100, it will say users created is 100, right? Now, you'll be done with the users. Now, you need to learn how to create a course, which is very much crucial, how to create a course. Mostly, most of the online courses that you take, a majority of them, they were built in using Moodle. Now, once you create a course, you'll see the similarities between the courses that you have taken online and the one that you are going to create for your learners, or rather your students. So for you to create a course, you need to go back to dashboard. You will get the menu on the left. You need to go back to dashboard. Once you are on the dashboard, you need to go to site administration. Once you are on site administration, you need to click on courses. Once you are on courses, you need to click on manage courses and categories. All right? Now, once you click on manage courses and categories, you will give you this, the screen that you see here. You need to click on create new category, and then you rename the category. After renaming the category, you need to click at the bottom. You will see save and display. Sorry, it's not here. Thanks. You will see save and display. You click it, and then now here where it says miscellaneous, you will see the name of the course that you just created, and then you will now create the course. This was the category. This is now the course. With the category, you can simply say senior phase or FET phase, doesn't matter, whichever category you prefer. Now the course will be the name of the course, right? You'll then now come and create the course. You'll follow, it will require the full name of the course, you'll put it there, and the short name. And when you see exclamation mark, it means that they are very crucial, they are very important, and then you cannot continue without putting anything there. So, but then when you see question mark, it means that it's just it's upon you to put something if you want to. It's not a must. So you'll put in the course name and the short name. After that, you'll come here and enroll users. The users that you have uploaded, and now you'll enroll them to the course. What is the difference between uploading users and enrolling users? In uploading users, was uploading users to your Moodle account, so that all your students will be there. But with the course, you find that some students are doing English, some they are doing another language. You'll have to come here and enroll to that particular course. It doesn't necessarily mean that all the learners will have the access to the course, only those which you enrolled. With plugins, I'll just be faster because time is no longer in my side. With the plugins, you need to upload the plugins. For you to upload the plugins, you need to go to dashboard again. Remember, every action you take, you need to first go back to the dashboard, then you come back to wherever you want to upload or to do that particular stuff. Now, dashboard, thereafter site administration, then plugins, and then install plugins. And then with installing plugins, there are two ways of installing plugins. It's either you install plugins from the Moodle plugins directory, or you install them from the zip file. But then with the zip file, I will explain it later. Now let me dwell much on the plugins directory. Plugins directory simply means you are going to download the plugins from online, right? So you simply click where it says install plugins from the Moodle plugins directory, and then it will take you to this page. You go to browse plugins. You don't have to log in here. You only go to browse plugins, right? And then you are going to browse the plugins you want. The name of the plugins is Gapfill. So you type in Gapfill, you search, and then you get the Gapfill plugins, then you download. After downloading the plugins, you now go back and upload them as a zip file, right? So you'll go to upload the plugins from zip file, and then you'll choose the file where it's downloaded. Normally it will be in the downloads, provided you didn't change the location. You choose any location, you upload it, and then you'll be done. So this was just quick, I know, but if you need any help, or maybe you have any question, you are